From the time that I was a teenager until just a couple of years ago, my parents owned a farm. It was in a little place called Aniseed Valley in Richmond, Nelson, New Zealand. And as a university student, I would spend my summers there. And boy, I've got some terrific memories of the place. Swimming in the river that ran through the property. The sound of the wind through the cottonwoods. The people of the valley who were such characters. And in particular, a whole bunch of memories centered around the activity of making hay.
People just descended on the place from all around. You know, they'd hear it going. Yeah. Oh, there's the hay going. We better go and help them get it in.
Yeah.
And kids and dogs and people and all ages, and, you know, and before long it was done, and then you'd be sitting around having a sucking on a beer or a coffee or a something or other at the end of it, and it was a great social occasion.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was awesome.
Everybody working together to get the hay in. As it happens, my dad had one of the only balers in the valley, and so he would contract to all the other farms around.
But I used to bale by ear, because as much as anything, you'd be listening for the sound of the baler to know whether it was working right, and it became quite refined, really. Mm-hmm. You know, the chicka 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 chicka, and the difference in maybe 100 revs on the rev counter made the difference between really good hay and bad. And you could just hear chicka 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 click clock 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 chicka 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 chicka. That, and that was the knots being tied, you see. And you'd listen for every knot. Yeah, that one's all right. And the next one, click clock click. Yeah, that's all right. And then you'd try to get, the ideal was to get 10 slices per bale, 10 to 12 slices per bale. So you had to have a pretty fat windrow of hay in order to do that. And you had to have your speed right so that it could scoop up all, because this massive great plunge. And so 10 of those would make a good bale.
Yeah.
click, 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 clock. The tone of it all, the rhythm of it all was really quite important.
Yeah, it's hard to put it into words, but there was something special about the place.
Often we've been away out on holiday, we'd come home and be singing, "Hey, it's good to be back home again." John Denver. Sometimes this old farm feels like a long lost friend, and it did. It was a great place. And it was pretty raw emotionally.
Still is, even 7 years later. The neighbours were just phenomenal. They helped us so much, and so we decided to invite them all to my birthday party. And that was everybody that surrounded us, and they were all friends and neighbours. And so I was thanking them for accepting us into their community, and for supporting us, and you know, for just taking us in, really. And one of them brought us back to even keel just simply by saying, "Oh, it was because you had the bailer."
Cats and dogs and people and all ages, and you know. And speed right. Kids and dogs and people and all ages. That was the knots being tied, you see. And you'd listen for every knot.